Daniel Tchaikovsky. You guys know him? Yeah. You got that sound exciting. So hold on, are you going to do that to me? Because I'm short. I didn't have my collar down. Because you were scratching your neck.
How many of you have actually heard me speak before? Yeah. Either on the Letting Go show or in person? Raise your hands. Okay, so about half-half. So I'm going to start with a... standing here. But I feel like I should be preaching if I'm right. Okay, so I'm going to start with a quick sort of exercise to do, which will show you really what letting go is about. So if you can all close your eyes, and I want you to think of someone or something that you want to feel better about in your life. Bring up the image in your mind of a person, of a situation, and go into yourself and see how you feel about this person or situation. And where in your body do you feel this? Do you feel it in your throat? In your heart? Or perhaps you feel it in your stomach? Maybe there's a slight tension. Maybe there's tightness. Maybe there's a pressure. Maybe even there's a pain, a physical pain. And could you just allow whatever is present to just be there without wanting to change it, without even wanting to feel better? Could you just do that just for now? Could you even let go of the want to feel better? And just accept yourself fully in this moment, the way you are. Letting go is really about acceptance of your current state. That is the first step. To allow everything to be exactly the way it is. All emotions, all feelings and thoughts are to be allowed. And once again, bring up the same person or situation that you want to feel better about and check in with yourself how you feel. Is the emotion more intense? Is it less, or has it not changed? Even if it hasn't changed at all, that's okay. We're not here to actually feel better when it comes to letting go. It's about getting better at feeling. And when you allow yourself to feel fully, unconditionally what you feel, in this moment, you give that energy that's stuck, the opportunity to be released from you. Check in with yourself once again, how you feel about this person or situation. Maybe the feeling has even moved to a different location. Maybe it was previously in your stomach and now it's gone to your throat. Perhaps it's intensified. Everything is okay. We're not trying to achieve a certain state with letting go. We're just allowing ourselves to just be. When you're ready, just open your eyes. Thank you for doing that. This is what I do with my clients, and this is what I encourage everyone to do at some point. And the reason is because we are often in a state of resistance to what is, to what is happening within us. And the reason we're in a state of resistance is because from childhood we've been conditioned to suppress our emotions. We've been conditioned to suppress anger, grief. We've been conditioned to suppress shame and guilt. We don't want to feel it. And when it comes up within us, we try and distract ourselves from these feelings, from these emotions. But these emotions offer the gateway to more freedom, to less limitation in our lives. And that's really important to understand, because we are effectively carrying a whole rucksack of these emotions, and most of us don't even know that we are. We think we've let go, we think we've let go of a lot of stuff, and even we've done work, perhaps we've done work for a few years about a certain person, and then along they come into our lives again, and they trigger us some more. How many of people have had that, when they thought they've let go and then they've realised, well, that person just, yeah, almost everyone, and including me as well. You know, my father died 11 years ago now, and, you know, I've written letters to him, you know, after he died. I've gone on long 10-day meditation retreats and I've cried for 8 hours. I've woken up in the middle of the night with having a dream about my father, sat down and meditated for 4 hours, let go, and then I thought, yeah, I've released, I've let go. But the other day, someone mentioned when their father died, and I realized there was a feeling within me, this contraction, this tightness, this feeling of sadness. And I'm like, Daniel, you still haven't let go. It's still there. Okay, so let me sit with it. Let me just allow myself to feel the way I do. And so I did. And I burst out into tears. And I burst out into tears when my friend's guinea pig died. Yeah, I was not expecting it. Her, you know, it was my girlfriend, and actually her daughters had 2 guinea pigs. And they said, and she rang me up, she wouldn't believe it. I've got the name of the guinea pig now.
Let it go.
Yeah. Yeah, and this intense sadness came up. But was that sadness related to the guinea pig? Who knows? Probably not. It may have even been related to my father and some unprocessed sadness, because all sadness effectively is the same, meaning that we carry a set quantity of emotional energy in our body, set quantity of sadness, like for example, or fear. And once we release a certain amount, let's say for example with regards to guinea pigs, then effectively the amount of sadness we carry in our body goes down. Yeah? So I'll give you an example. I had a friend of mine who had this fear of his father. His father's quite famous, and he used to beat him up when he was younger. And he always carried this fear of his dad. And one day we go away to this retreat, me and him, and we go on a retreat, he lets go during that retreat, and he rings me up about 3 days later, and he says, Danny, you wouldn't believe what? My fear of spiders has gone away. Because he let go of his fear of his father, that was directly connected with the amount of fear he carried within him. So when he let go of his fear of his father, his fear of spiders went away. Yeah. And this is what's happened to me as well. When I've let go, that one night where I stayed up for 4 hours working with this fear process, it took me 4 hours, wave after wave of fear would come and go, come and go, come and go. Yeah. I just sat with it because it came up in the form of a nightmare. I'm like, okay. At one point, I thought the fear was so intense, I thought I was going to die. I don't know if anyone's had fear that intense. Okay, a few people shaking their heads. But I had this fear so intense, I thought I was going to part. And you know what I thought to myself? Fuck it. Yeah. I am prepared to die, I said to myself. I actually said that. You know what? I'm tired of living in fear. I'm tired of being afraid. So I thought, okay, I'm going to face this. I don't care how intense it gets, I'm going to face it. And so I did. And so for the next 4 hours, wave after wave of fear would come and go, come and go. Eventually, my mind ended up going back to a story when I was about 8 years of age, when I used to live in this house, and I realized that fear, that element of fear, came from an incident that happened then. Yeah, I remember my parents saying to me, so it was my mum and sister, they were in the kitchen, and I come run screaming from my bedroom saying, there's someone in my room, there's someone in my room. Yeah, they come rushing into a room and no one's there. And we used to live, and the place that we lived was next to a hospital. It was called Mentor Asylum, Grayling Wheel Mentor Asylum. And later on, I found out that this was the most haunted hospital in the UK. Now, I can't even remember this, but during this, the nightmare that came up, all the memories came back. And I sat with them, and I processed that fear. And when I finished processing it, I go into work the next day. I've hardly had any sleep, but I am so energetic. I am so alert. And I realize over the next 3 months, yeah, the fear in every aspect of my life had gone down. My fear in making business decisions, my fear in speaking to my ex-wife, you know, my fear in public speaking had gone down as well. And I'd noticed it, and that one, quantity of fear that I had processed that perhaps came from my childhood. And even then, maybe it wasn't even from my childhood, maybe it was from even past lives, if you believe that. And when I let it go, I noticed I was less afraid. I even realized after that incident, I had a fear of swimming, of, you know, perhaps it was actually a fear of drowning. And I went into the pool and I remember feeling differently. And then I realized that I had carried a fear into a swimming pool that I never realized that I had. And often this is what happens. When we let go, we realize what we were really carrying. We realize how much we actually had within us. But when we're holding on to it, we've been holding on to it for so long, we don't know. We don't even notice that. And that's why often when you ask people, and probably those closest to you, you can see this, that when you ask them, you know, you ask them about, you know, how do you feel about so-and-so, maybe an ex or, you know, their parents, and they're like, yeah, I'm okay with that. I'm all right. But there you can tell they're still brewing about something. Yeah. They're in that state of not knowing. That's why awareness, you know, what Coach Astrid was saying earlier about awareness is the first step. Being aware of actually what we are feeling. And that awareness brings clarity and okay. Now I'm feeling this way. Now all you need is courage to take that step and to just feel your emotions without distracting yourself in any way, without distracting yourself with your phone, into overworking, alcohol, sex, whatever it is. And once you do that, then you can feel. Yeah. And as the feeling stays within you, it may shift, it may change, but eventually it will go. Every feeling felt consciously will go. And when it goes, you're less afraid. You carry less guilt, less shame. Because the feelings we've suppressed inside of us attract people and circumstances into our lives for the purpose of the integration of those feelings. So when we have anger, and we have a lot of anger, I know someone that started up a Facebook page called I Fucking Hate Cyclists. Yeah. He was interviewed by the BBC. He was on a documentary as well, and he is constantly angry, and he's like, there's so many angry people around, yeah? And he's attracting these people into his life to show him what is within him, yeah? And he suffers from some illnesses as well. And I have this amazing book which shows you the true root emotional causes of illnesses. And I'm saying, he told me his illness, so I get the book, I'm reading it out. And I'm like, oh my God, this is exactly him. Right. And I take the book to his wife as well. She's like, oh my God, this is exactly him. And I thought, I'm gonna go speak with you, and I'm gonna say, you know, hopefully you'll see what's carrying, yeah? Because he wanted to know, because he knows what I did. So I go taking the book and I read it out, and I'm like, he's going to get it, he's going to see it, he's going to... He was like, Daniel, what are you bringing me this for? I'm like, really? you don't see how anger... Okay, all right. Yeah. But he attracted people and circumstances into his life, angry people, angry situations, to help him trip that anger to help that anger be triggered so it can be let go of. If he ever gets to the state where he will truly let go of that, he will no longer need to attract those people into his life, because that energy isn't inside of him. This is the same for every feeling you have. Guilt, shame. Guilt in certain cultures, like for example the Indian culture, yeah, there's a lot of, you know, you bring shame on the family, yeah, you know, and you're made to feel guilty because they're carrying that as a culture. Yeah, Polish people, where my background, they carry certain energetic emotional imprint. If anyone's heard of Eckhart Tolle, he calls it the pain body. They're carrying that, and it's passed on from generation to generation. From, you know, from grandparents to parents to, yeah. And it's an energy, it's an emotional energy. And when it's felt, it's let go of. And now you no longer need to pass it on to your kids. And it's absolutely amazing when this happens, because you start to see the people around you change when you let go. When you let go of your anger, guilt, shame, sadness. For example, grief is the gateway emotion to connection and love. Meaning, if you've suppressed grief, and as a man, yeah, and as men, we carry a lot of suppressed grief, which means we're disconnected a lot of the time. When we're able to feel the grief and release it, now all of a sudden we gain connection to people. Now, we previously were disconnected, and we've let go of the grief, and that opens the gateway to more love in our lives, more true connection. I'm going to be speaking later on a Zoom call about single fathers. And a lot of time, you know, single fathers are disconnected from their children. Some out of choice, some because of their the child's mother. Now, it's one of my beliefs that when a man lets go of a grief, inside of him and a woman, then he will start to reconnect. Things will start to happen in his experience that wouldn't have happened had he held on to the grief. He might get a call from his ex-wife who suddenly had a change of mind, saying, you can now see your son or daughter. Yeah? But it's the same with women. You know, women carry suppressed grief as well. So when they let go, now all of a sudden they reconnect perhaps with people that they hated before. And this is what happened with myself and my ex-wife. When I got divorced, she became very angry at me for some reason. I know you're doubting, yeah. There's always a reason, exactly, yeah. But for me, the reason was I understood something that this was happening for a reason, okay? Because previously, when we were in a marriage, we actually had quite a good relationship, but I was a bit disconnected. Now, when she was angry, I would go within myself, okay, and ask myself, what do I need to look at within myself? And I think, okay, first thing is, I need to let go of the anger. Because the anger is always the cover emotion, covers things up. When I let go of the anger towards her, what I discovered was sadness. Sadness about losing the family. Sadness about losing her and my daughter. And when I let go of the sadness, now she shifted, she changed. She began to be different to me. And it would be funny, as I would let go, literally a day later, sometimes even 4 hours later, she'd ring me up and say, you know what I said? I'm really sorry, I didn't mean that. And the more I let go, the more longer period of time we became friends for. And this was, you know, I understood how this worked, but still it's amazing that when you let go, the people around you change. And each time, and I remember going past my old house and feeling sadness there, and I'm like, okay, let me park the car, sit down, feel the sadness, and then go. And I'd done that, she would shift. Yeah, she now no longer became angry at me. And it would be and once I tried to tell her this, and she said, no, it's because I decided to. And maybe she did decide to. But it was uncanny from my experience how when I let go, so did she. Because ultimately, we're all one. We're all connected, all of us. There is no separation. And if we're all connected, we're all one, then what you do, how you act and how you let go will change the people around you. In fact, it changes the whole planet. So every single time you let go on an individual basis, you affect everyone in this room and everyone on the planet at some level. Yeah, and that's why doing this work is so powerful. Like doing any kind of work like this, mindfulness, affirmations, it's so powerful because you're changing, you're giving that ability, you're helping others change as well. So I'm going to round it off for there. Thank you so much for this. I'm really hoping you've found some benefit from my talk. Raise your hands if you did find a bit of benefit. Great, excellent. So all I want to say to you, if you have an opportunity in the future, you know, to consciously feel your emotions, do so. Sit down, don't avoid it, because on the other side of that is more freedom, more love, more connection with everyone. Thank you.
Letting go, we're going to give you 5 minutes to go to the toilet, bathroom, have a cup of coffee, say hello to somebody you haven't seen, and stuff like that.
Give us time to be back.
The time now is 11:30, so 11:35, please. Literally 5 minutes.